supposed to tell you something I remember about high school. So what I really remember about high school is not the classes, it's the time out of class. It's yearbook, it's band trips, it's the parties that we had, the lasagna parties we had at Shirley's place when her parents were at the farm. All that extra time that we spent together, like really, I don't know, I guess we did pretty good in classes. I think I remember talking Mr. Stefani into giving me an extension, which was a big deal at the time. Trying to get something past him was a big deal. The time we spent in class when we were not actually doing what we were supposed to do, used to head down to my parents' place, drink tea, and basically not do stuff. But we pretended we were working in the yearbook, and we got away with it because we were scholastic kids. That was the best part. Anyway, that's about it. What I really remember about high school is how the boys were so geeky. Man, oh man, especially that Bruce Walgren.
Oh yeah.
No, they were a great bunch of kids. Just true. Yeah, that's right. Before nerds were cool.
That's right. So the most memorable story for me would be the discovery of the great blue bear hanging from the gym at LBR, where it was stolen by the rugby team and it got put in gym ceiling. That's my most memorable story. Mr. Jorgensen teaching me math, saving my skin. So I passed math 11.
So my favorite memory of 1983 was smoking in the courtyard, because we were allowed to do that, and I smoked for a long time, and having the hen party at my mom and dad's property, and worrying all night about all the orangutan boys that showed up, and all the beer bottles that got broken. Cheers. I think probably the best memory or funniest memory is getting locked in the biology storeroom
with George Kennedy,
my friends all locked me in there. I'm not sure why. We were locked in there.
And biology with Fred Young was awesome. So how did he get out?
How did they eventually let us out?
Favorite memories of high school stories. I guess some of my favorite memories of high school are playing in the rock band with the guys. They've been my friends ever since. Don't see them all that often, but I still consider them my best friends. And there's a few performances that stand out. Probably one of them was the time that my pants split all the way down the back, and Dan Pleasance just about lost his drum kit because he was laughing so hard behind me. Yes, also band tours with the school band. Lots of fun on those. And just lots of good friends and good times.
You're on.
You're on now.
You're on the spot.
To do what? To talk about the fact that John and I had our first kiss when I was in grade 7?
It's actually, it's grade 5, actually.
Five?
Yeah,
okay.
That's right. Grade 5, yeah. First kiss, that's right.
That's right. Because this is sort of those gem-like memories you never
you and Heather McElwain.
I know.
Bruce
Young.
And it was basically a Mexican standoff at that point.
I know, it was like, you go first. You go first.
And I think you shot first.
Is that everything about me, Jim? Do you need to know more?
That was good memory. And you gave me that little leather.
Oh my god, the little leather
bracelet. You put the little leather bracelet on.
Friends for life.
Yeah.
And then I found you on Facebook, and that was like the first one. I was like, oh, I'm gonna talk to
you. Yeah, what, 2007 or something?
A while ago, I was still living in Edmonton.
Good memories.
So I remember Mr. McClelland. This is science class of some sort. He's walking past my desk, we're writing a test. I think he was filling in for Mr. Spencer or something like that. He picks up my arm and he looks at it and he says, "You are not very hairy for a white person." And then he puts my arm down and goes away again. And that's the end of my story.
We told him that if he couldn't wouldn't eat butterflies, we wouldn't let him start medicine that, so we ate butterflies on the front of the bus.
JR, Gwen, Nora, Tracy McDonald. I tried to make it look like the guys did it on our stag night. Peeing in the hallway.
That was not.
Okay, that was a good story.
Yeah, that was a good one, yeah.
That it might be kind of a nice thing for us to remember our classmates that have passed on. And so I'm just going to read the list for those of you who haven't had a chance, and we'll raise a glass in their honor after I do that. And then you guys can ask who the heck they were and where they went, you know. So from our class, Darcy Purdy, Kirsty Lockhart, Robert Calhoun, Don Hunt, Dalton Williams, Holly McKinnon, Sabina Karachik, Elizabeth Bidnoff, Jackie King, and Jeff Wilson. From the class of 84, we have Ed Pody, Tammy Palmer, Brenda Barnes, and Roger Fitchett. And from the class of 82, we have Chris McLean, Moira Eggleston, Richard Greenwood, Gary McKinn, Daryl Wintemute, Darren Boyd, Terry Webb. Anyone else that have a mention? So maybe we just, to our friends that have... Brad Albrecht. So we'll raise a glass to our friends that have gone before us.
Yeah. to be as sweet as hot. It's good. Oh, my love, come home. Oh, my love, hold me.
Yeah, I do not remember much.
You don't remember much. What year did you graduate?
83.
Oh my God, you remember something.
I do remember something. And I got a picture, right? So obviously, right?
Okay, well, I'm
going to
shoot these pictures now.
Okay.
All over.